So how did I go from a political science degree to a software engineer in 6 months without dropping 20K on a bootcamp? Well, today I'm here to share my story and hopefully I can give you guys advice if you are about to start this journey. Definitely check out the description box because I'll be leaving all the resources I used during my journey. And also make sure to check the comment section for timestamps, so in case you want to kind of move ahead or move to the certain parts that you want to watch in this video. And finally, make sure to like and subscribe to show this channel some love. And it encourages me to keep making videos like this. Let's start off in June 2016. I just graduated from college with a political science degree. Yes, I know, like political science, what was I thinking when I got that degree? Well, quite frankly, I was thinking that I was gonna go into law school and become a lawyer. And at that point, I'd actually gotten a job in a financial service firm in their regulatory and compliance division. This division was filled with lawyers, and our job was to help private equity firms and hedge funds create compliance programs. So we had a lot of amazing lawyers working at the firm. And I was so excited to be at this job and to sort of experience what life would look like if I decided to become a lawyer. Well, 5 months later, I realized, damn, I gotta get out of here because it wasn't for me. Like, there were many reasons why I thought this wasn't necessarily a good fit for me. The top three being that, one, I thought the work was just very boring and dry. Two, the lawyers at the firm hated their jobs. The one thing they always told me when they found out that I wanted to be a lawyer too was that this is one of the worst career fields you can go to. They just didn't think that a law degree was worth it in this day and age, given the law school loans that they had to deal with. Finally, it just was not the best culture fit for me. So when I realized that, wow, I don't want to continue working at this job and I don't want to become a lawyer, I was definitely in a dark place. I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. Let me give you a little bit of a context about why I decided to even be a lawyer. So when I was in college, I bounced around doing different majors. Like, I honestly was confused in college. I had no idea what I wanted to study at all. Plus, I had Nigerian parents who gave me only three career options. They said I could be a doctor, I could be a lawyer, or I could be a disgrace. And because I was really concerned about pleasing them at that age, I decided to try to become a doctor. But then after taking a lot of science classes in college, I realized, science is not for me. Because I was also just bouncing around after deciding not to be pre-med, I also tried a little bit of computer science in college. So I took about three CS courses, which were all intro level, and I really enjoyed those classes, but I wasn't sure about if going that route was a good trajectory for me, because quite frankly, I just didn't have a lot of information about what it was like to be a software engineer. I decided, okay, you know what? So disgrace is out of the option. Being a doctor isn't for me. Okay, let's just go with lawyer. That sounds like a good fit. And I really like my humanities classes too. So going back to where I was at my job, thinking about leaving. So I thought about college and I thought about how much I enjoyed my CS courses, that I decided, maybe I should look into if computer science would be a good career path for me. So what that entailed was me doing a lot of intense research and asking anyone I knew who was a computer scientist or software engineer all the information possible. Like, I was DMing people on Reddit, like talking to people in real life, just trying to get as much information about what it was like to be a software engineer. Because at this point in my life, even though I was still pretty young, I thought that, listen, I can't keep bouncing around and being not sure about what I want to do in the future. If this is what I want to do, I should see this as a very long-term path, like a path that I would be doing for the next 10 to 15 years. Like, I didn't want to take this career choice lightly. So I wanted to do enough research to make sure that I was making the right decision. But after doing a lot of research, I decided, you know what? Like, I think this is a great career path for me. Plus, like, if I decide that I don't want to do this in the future, there are other different career paths where knowing how to program could be very useful and helpful. So at that point, I was like, what are my options? Like, how do I go about this path and how do I do this? So at that time, looking at my options, I could either get a bachelor's of science in computer science, I could get a master's degree in computer science, or I could do a boot camp. But I was looking at my bank account and it was looking kind of low. But after doing research, I thought, okay, listen, I already have a little bit of understanding of programming. And from talking to other software engineers, it seems like computer science is a field that you can actually self-study. Even though it's very difficult, you can self-study and become a software engineer. So I thought, you know what, listen, if I really want to do this, let me just go the self-study route, because quite frankly, I just don't have money to do the other options. But after doing research, I came across something called the Recur Center. First of all, the most important thing is that it's free. The second most important thing is what it is, which you can find on their website. But just to give you a little bit of overview, they're a self-directed educational retreat for software engineers. So if you already know how to program, you can join this community of engineers and spend about 3 months building projects that you want to build. Self-directed means that they don't teach you anything in terms of there aren't formal classes like a boot camp. Community-based means that you get to be surrounded by a lot of really motivated and driven software engineers, or people who are aspiring to be software engineers. And most importantly, they have a job resource center, which helps connect you with different companies in the New York City SF area. As a self-taught engineer, it can be really hard to network with other engineers. So having a community and having then an entire company that's going to help you eventually find a job is extremely useful. How did I prepare for the Recur Center? So every single morning before the job I hated, I spent about a couple hours regaining my coding skills, which means that I used this book and started to just sort of like flesh out my understanding of Java and start building projects. When I had like two projects under my belt, I decided, okay, let's go ahead and apply to the Recur Center and see if they'll accept me. Okay, so luckily I got into the program. Because I knew this would be a self-directed program, I had to be very disciplined with what I wanted to do. So before the program even started, I created a schedule for myself and a roadmap for myself, because like I couldn't play, like I wasn't here to play. I had to get a job after the program or else I would be homeless. Okay, so what was my schedule and what was my plan of action while I was at the Recur Center? I can kind of split that up into four steps. So the first one was to learn and understand data structures and algorithms. Not only is learning data structures and algorithms important for you being an engineer and just programming, it's also really important for the interview process, where you're basically being asked mostly data structures and algorithms questions. The second plan of action was to learn Python and be able to create a program in Python. Just by doing a little bit of research, I could see that Python was a very popular engineering language, and I felt like, okay, let me add that to my toolkit. The third step for me was to build projects that I could show to employers. Fourth plan of action was really important, which was to network, meet as many engineers as possible. So those were the four most important things that I had to do at the Recur Center. So it was a really stressful period of time. Like I was grinding out there. Like I would come in early, leave late. Every single day at the Recur Center, I would dedicate to following these four things, four goals that I had. So by July 2017, the program was over. And I was looking at my bank account and I was like, oh, okay. So I have about 3 months left of money, or else I'm gonna get my butt out of New York City. I have to figure this out, right? So how was the interview process for me? I'm gonna be honest and tell you that I failed a lot of interviews. I failed HackerRank test that I was given. I failed phone screens, failed onsites. I failed a bunch of times, but you know what's really funny is that the more you're doing interviews and you're working on interview prep is that you start noticing a lot of patterns reappearing. Like I got asked the same couple of questions or same couple of types of questions multiple times, and after a while, like once I failed it once, like I wouldn't fail it again, because guess what, I'd already seen this question before, so like I should already know how to answer it. And that's the thing, if you're in the interview process right now, just keep pushing. I promise you, you'll get a job eventually, as long as you're making sure if you get a question wrong, you understand why you got it wrong, and you do questions like that on LeetCode, you'll eventually get it, because I feel like interview prep is something that you can practice for and you can get better, even though there is a lot of luck in the process. What are the resources that I'd recommend for interview prep? So I would recommend that you do the very classic Cracking the Coding Interview. Check out that book. If you do that book front to back, you're pretty much set. If you want a little bit more advanced book on just sort of interview prep, definitely check out Elements of Programming Interview. Another thing that I would recommend is you go on LeetCode. I think this is a very popular advice. Go on LeetCode and try to answer as many questions as possible. If there's a certain company you're targeting, if you're targeting Google, Facebook, go on their section of LeetCode.
And just skip all of the problems.
If you can. I know like there can be up to 600 problems, but just try to do as much as possible. I think like 200 is like a good amount to do. And then the last tip I would give if you're doing in the interview process is to do as many mock interviews as possible. Like when you're practicing and studying by yourself, it's not the same experience at all. Especially if you're doing LeetCode and you're just typing on the computer, a lot of jobs, like that's not how the interview process works. You have to get a whiteboard. Like guys, I actually have a whiteboard in my room. Wait, let me bring it out because I have a whiteboard. Get yourself a whiteboard, okay? If you want to practice like online interviews, like I know for a lot of the first round of the interview process, if you don't get a hacker rank, you get a phone screen, and that requires you to kind of like hop on the phone and do like live coding. You should check out Interview.io and Pramp.io. After failing a bunch of interviews, grinding it out, I eventually got a job, and that's where I've been for the past 2.5 years. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I honestly feel so blessed to be a software engineer. If you have any questions, definitely feel free to leave them down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.